What's going on, Seahawks fans? So, yesterday was the worst day in football, as a lot of players like to regard to it, because it seems like everybody and their mother got cut yesterday. Like, the Vikings released Alex Boone. There were some other surprising cuts, but in terms of, you know, us Seahawks fans, our most surprising cut was how Kasen Williams was cut after an incredible preseason, an absolutely amazing preseason, and became like a really big name to us Seahawks fans. I don't really know a Seahawks fan who wasn't upset about him getting cut yesterday. And you know, I just have a little bit of theories on why. Sorry, I just have like a little bit of theories on why he was cut yesterday. So I feel like there's two reasons. One, Pete Carroll and his play calling don't really fit. Like, maybe he doesn't really fit the offense. But the only thing that I have, like, that made me think that he definitely got a roster spot was because, you know, Jermaine Kearse getting traded. Kasen was pretty much like almost guaranteed a roster spot. That was the problem that I had, because with Jermaine Kearse gone, I thought that there was no way that Kasen Williams didn't get a roster spot, because not only is Kasen Williams bigger, but he's like a bigger overall, like more athletic. Not really more athletic, but he's just like a bigger body receiver. I just felt like he would fit in perfectly, but I guess, like, some people are saying that Pete Carroll and John Schneider don't really know what they're doing, but they do. Like, guys, like, they know what they're doing. They saw something that we didn't. There's got to be a reason why it got cut, because he had an amazing preseason. There's got to be a pretty big reason why he got cut. Either that or it's just a bad move. But that was my first theory. And then the second one is that Pete Carroll, if you are a Seahawks fan, you know that Pete Carroll does not like players who are, like, he can substitute them in at places. Like, it's the same thing with wide receiver, how Doug Baldwin, you know, against the Eagles last year, he threw a touchdown pass because, like, Pete Carroll loves players that he can do with that. Same thing with, like, Tanner McAvoy, who actually went out at wide receiver at one point. Like, Pete Carroll's just a coach who loves guys that don't just play one position. Same thing how he put Russell Wilson out at wide receiver at one point during that one play where Doug Baldwin threw the touchdown. And I feel like Tanner McAvoy, because some people always wonder, like, what does Tanner McAvoy do that Kasen Williams doesn't? But a lot of people don't understand how, like, versatile Tanner McAvoy is. And so I feel like that's the reason why, those are just two reasons why that they cut him. Because Pete Carroll is a coach who really likes when players can do more than one thing. And if you are a Seahawks fan, you probably know that. But I feel like a lot of people are missing the point there, because, but one move that I don't really understand, why does Kenny Lawler get a roster spot, but Kasen Williams doesn't? I don't like Kenny Lawler at all. I really don't think he's that good of a receiver, but that's just me. But I'm hoping he proves me wrong, because we are going to need some receiver help. But that's really all I can say about this in terms of him getting cut. So this is just going to be like a small little short little fantasy advice for you guys. I would pick up Paul Richardson and Tyler Lockett on fantasy, because I feel like those two now are, one question that I have is, how is Tyler Lockett going to fit into a second receiver role? Because Paul Richardson cannot play second receiver. I don't think he can. So I feel like, how is Tyler Lockett going to fit into that number two receiver role? Because he's always been a slot receiver. He always has been. So it's going to be interesting to see how Seattle handles that, because I don't, like, maybe Amara Darbo goes into the slot. Maybe he becomes a number two wide receiver. I don't really know. It's going to be interesting to see what we do at the start of the season. So that's just like a little bit of fantasy advice. I would pick up Paul Richardson or Tyler Lockett. Me personally, I picked up Tyler Lockett because I think he'll earn the number two starting spot. But I guess his health is a little bit of a concern. So we have to, you know, pretty much what I'm trying to say here is, don't get, you know, discouraged about this season all because we released Kasen Williams. Because like, we have other players. Like, we still have a very good defense. We still have a pretty good offense. So I'm just saying, you know, don't get, you know, we're not going to, you know, losing Kasen Williams really doesn't affect the season that much. But anyway, that's all I can say for this, is that, you know, Pete Carroll, he likes players that can do more, and maybe that's not what Kasen Williams can do. But I am still upset that he got cut, because what made me even, like, a little bit more upset was how he said that, You know how he said that he didn't want to be on a practice squad anymore and how he really wanted to make the roster. I'm fully convinced he probably thought that he was going to make the roster, ended up not making it. So that's all I can say for this video, guys. Leave your comments down below why he might have gotten a cut. I will definitely listen. I'll definitely respond. But that's all I can say, guys, is that, you know, he just doesn't. Maybe he only fits in a run role. Maybe he just doesn't fit the offense. But I'm not Pete Carroll. So just leave your opinions down below, and, you know, let's start a little bit of a discussion. And anyway, baby, go Hawks.